How do you extract Amazon data? Do you go and copy everything you need into an Excel sheet by hand? If you need large amounts of data, it's probably not the smartest move. Businesses collect data from Amazon for many purposes, such as monitoring prices, creating a product comparison page, or doing keyword research. Let's imagine that Tom has an e-commerce business where he sells furniture. Once in a while, he needs to do some competitor analysis. One of the best places to collect data for such an analysis is Amazon. So he goes on Amazon, searches for kitchen table, and he gets over 2,000 results. That's way too much data to copy manually. But Tom doesn't give up so fast. Instead of copying and pasting each of the product's titles, price, and ratings for a whole day, he gives web scraping a shot. Web scraping is a process of collecting data from the web. Usually, it's done automatically, using web scraping software or custom-built scripts. If Tom knew how to code, he'd probably just use a web scraping framework like Scrapy, Selenium, or web scraping libraries like Beautiful Soup, Puppeteer, or many others. But Tom is foreign to coding, so he'd rather choose a no-code scraper like ParseHub or Octopass. For large-scale products and enterprises that scrape often, there are also data collection services provided by companies like Zeit. They not only scrape for you, but also solve all of the challenges that you might face on the way. So you only need to tell them your needs and you get the data. Would you like a more detailed review of the best web scraping tools? Let us know down in the comments. But we don't have such a large need, so let's try scraping Amazon with Octopass. We chose Octopass for this tutorial because it's quite easy to use and works for everyone, even for people who don't have experience in coding. Here's what we'll have to do. First, we'll download Octopass. It's a free tool up to a certain point. If you buy the standard plan, which costs $75 a month, you'll also get Octopass task templates, which will help you scrape Amazon even easier. But for the sake of this tutorial, we'll scrape manually using the free version of Octopass. Second, we'll go on Amazon, search for kitchen table, and copy the URL when the page loads. Third, we'll go to Octopass and start a new task. Next, we'll enter the URL that we've copied, press enter, and wait while Octopass is detecting web page data. As you can see, Octopass automatically detected and extracted product titles, prices, URLs, and reviews. But if we need some other types of data exported as well, for example, product images, then we'll just select a couple of the images starting from the first one, and Octopass will export the rest. Keep in mind that some products on Amazon are sponsored, some are standard products, and some are recommended by Amazon. So we need to figure out each of these classes separately. Next, we'll click Create Workflow. Then we'll scroll down, click Next, and loop click single URL. This will ensure we'll export products from more than just the first page of Amazon. Finally, we click Save and Run. This gives an option to either run the task on your device or in the cloud. You can also choose to run the task now or schedule it for later. It's very useful for updating your data automatically. When the task is complete, we can simply export the data to a selected format. But what if a task cannot be completed? Ugh. Unless you're scraping tiny websites in the middle of internet nowhere, you've probably encountered a CAPTCHA. The main purpose of CAPTCHA tests is to filter human traffic from bots. And yes, web scrapers are bots. They do so by presenting various challenges to website visitors. In the case of Amazon, you'll most likely have to type in some kind of distorted text. If your web scraping activity starts to look suspicious, the website can give you a CAPTCHA to solve, or it might simply block you from browsing the website altogether. To avoid CAPTCHAs and blocks, when web scraping, you'll need a quality proxy network. If you're completely new to proxies, then don't worry. You've got Proxyway here to help you out. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for new videos about proxies every week. So how do you choose proxies for Amazon? There are two main types of proxies, data center and residential. Data center proxies are a popular choice for scraping Amazon due to their raw power and lower price. Still, businesses often choose residential IPs to access more locations, reduce the possibility of blocks or data poisoning. Here at Proxyway, for the third year in a row, we released a proxy market research. It's an extensive, illustrated, 47-page analysis of the 8 leading residential proxy services. The research is based on comprehensive testing. In total, we made over 16 million connection requests to 8 major residential IP providers. You can find the complete research linked below this video, where we discuss web scraping of other e-commerce sites like AliExpress, Craigslist, or Walmart. But let's take a short look to determine which proxies work best for scraping Amazon. Perhaps the main desired characteristics for proxies used in e-commerce is, of course, speed. That's because you often want to scrape thousands of pages, and it takes forever with slow proxies. According to our tests, you can expect the lowest response time from Smart Proxy, OxyLabs, and Bright Data. Another important criterion that helps to scrape e-commerce websites quickly is the ability to scale well. So we put the provider's residential proxy servers under load, making up to 500 connection requests every second. We got the best results from Smart Proxy, OxyLabs, Bright Data, and Soaks. Another important factor is stability, especially when the data needs to be fresh at all times. Once again, Bright Data, OxyLabs, Smart Proxy, and Soaks were the best at it. Considering the most important features that we mentioned, we can recommend the following providers for your next Amazon web scraping project. OxyLabs, which demonstrated amazing results in all areas. For large-scale scraping, it also has premium features and services, which do most of the job for you. Bright Data. Besides being a great performer, this provider was exceptionally stable. It also provides premium data collection services like OxyLabs. Smart Proxy. During our tests, Smart Proxy was surprisingly close, or even better than proxy veterans, Bright Data and OxyLabs. We mentioned in our previous video, Smart Proxy is known for great price-to-value ratio. It might not have as many fancy tools as the other two, but it can definitely save you some money. Even though the other providers didn't reach the level of the 3 market leaders, we have 2 more honorable mentions. Soaks. It caught our eye with stability and resilience under load. And NetNut, because of its reasonable performance in all areas, as well as being faster than Soaks. Interested in one of the providers? You'll find all the links to their websites in the description box below. For more detailed proxy reviews, we prepared this playlist for you. So, see you there.